Hey everybody, and welcome to a brand new, okay, I said bland like the first time, brand new, nothing here is bland, except, I don't know, maybe that elephant. I just realized it's actually winking at me, I'm very disturbed. Anyways, we're playing Far Cry 4. I think I'm gonna go normal with this one. Oh, that's, was not expecting that, but sure, whatever. Now you may ask, why am I doing this in the middle of Far Cry 3? Did I lose all my Far Cry 3 footage? I mean, that sounds like me. Look, that whole hard drive incident was horrible. I had to re-record so many things, including a huge collectathon that I had planned. It was supposed to go up this year, maybe last, I don't know. Just, I think maybe that was a Christmas thing. But the point is, and I lost a lot of things that time, super regretting it, even now, so much wasted time and potential. But I've decided to move on. And after liking Far Cry 3 so much, and getting a taste of Far Cry Primal, I decided to, well, okay, that's not my name, but, you know, sure, you can call me whatever. It's better than my actual name, I think. No, actually, it's definitely better than my actual name. Anyways, I decided to branch out. I decided to go into the Noble Number 4. I don't think that's a real place, Mom or Dad.
Mr. Gale, this is Chet Peterson from the U.S. Embassy here in Patna.
I don't really care unless you're Chet, you betcha.
For a tourist visa for India with further travel to
I thought it was Kairat.
Your status as a U.S. citizen, as we have no official records regarding your karate citizenship. Furthermore, I must legally advise you against traveling into Karat. Official diplomatic presence in Karat due to the civil unrest with the Golden Path.
Yeah, this is definite Far Cry problematic stuff. Okay, there's a monkey there. Why are you asking me about the passport now? What if I didn't have it? Would you just come on. You should have checked for this a long time ago. Okay, so apparently the monkey is just a normal thing. Is that a golf club?
What's happening?
Is that a metal detector? I think it's a metal detector. So they're talking another language, right? When I start playing this game, what's going to make them start just immediately talking English? Wait, what? The heck? Okay, cool, those guys are dead, and that guy is dead. Wait, why did he just stand there with a gun? Okay, that should have hit me. Okay, so a question. What did you think was going to happen? They have metal detectors! I'm... Okay, don't shoot! Please. Oh, okay, cool. I thought he was dead. So, how's it going?
I distinctly remember saying, stop. Yes, stop the bus. Not shoot the bus.
I mean, shooting the bus, stop the bus.
I'm very particular with my words. Stop. Shoot. Stop. Shoot. Do those words sound the same?
I mean, maybe in one other language.
I'm sorry, I didn't hear you. What'd you say?
They got out of control.
Got out of control.
This is the vast.
I hate when things get out of control. One fucking job, you couldn't fucking do that!
Wow, okay, cool, that's the boss. I'm just gonna walk over here. Oh, right, I'm gonna not do anything.
And I got blood on my fucking shells.
I mean, that was more your fault.
At least there's a silver lining. You didn't completely fuck it up. I recognize those eyes anywhere. I'm so sorry about this. This was supposed to be... Well, not this. We have a party waiting for you.
Oh, really?
But I don't think I know your name. Who is this? Hmm? Is this your plus one?
I really don't know. I just got here.
Strong silent type. I like it. I am terribly embarrassed about all of this. This was supposed to be... Very simple, but you know, if you give food to monkeys, they just throw their shit at each other.
I mean, there are actual monkeys on the bus.
For just a moment, I want to get a little picture right into the camera.
Oh, cool. Now I know what I am. Now I know what I look like.
Awesome.
Oh!
Don't worry about a thing, my boy. This will soon be behind us. We'll be off on a grand adventure.
What happened to the pot with my mom or dad's ashes?
You and I are gonna tear shit up!
Yay! Okay, nope. They put the bag over my head.
Should I stay or should I go?
I don't think I have a choice of whether I stay or go. They pretty much want me to stay. So this is the part where I run, because there's always a part where I run. Do I move? I'm seeing nothing. Is...
You give my congratulations to Ashley on your next visit home. I must say, Paul, your little corner of Kiratu is rather beautiful.
Okay, good. I'm not... It wasn't, you know, actual glitching. So
wry smile betrays you again, Duplume.
Is this dialogue important? I feel like these things are going to be important.
Well, go on, take the bloody bag off his head.
Okay, it was still the bag on my head. Oh, this sunlight. Wait, are those the monkeys?
So, fresh start. Introductions. Ajay Gale, our guest of honor. Paul, our very gracious host. The little monkey, whose name I still don't know. Of course, pagan name.
I...
Really don't remember me, do you?
I think I'd remember somebody like you if I, you know, were in my memory banks.
I need cash.
How much do you need?
All of it. Thank you. Here we go. All right. Look at this with a smile.
Okay. So, am I not going to say anything?
That's you. That's me.
Oh, okay. Finally.
Well, I'm not so sure anymore. Now, your mother... Mother, on the other hand,
hey,
she understood me. She knew me in a way that no one ever did.
Is he tasting the ashes?
Takes me back.
That's disgusting.
The last time I saw Ishwari was years ago. She told me she loved me. Women, they can do that. They can tell you they love you in a moment and mean it. Men, on the other hand. No, men only really love you in hindsight. And too much distance has built up.
I mean, I get the understanding here, but I don't completely agree on a general sense.
So, when your mother decided to flee to the United States with you on her hip.
There's a lot of lag happening.
I couldn't help but blame myself.
What's going on?
It's not me. No. It was the fucking Golden Path.
Was there any need for that? You're ruining my dinner right now.
Did no one ever teach you that it's rude to text at the table?
Text? I mean...
Really, guys? We're not checking for these anymore?
You know, that's actually a very good...
RJ Gale. You'll love this part.
That's like a very good point.
Help. A text for help.
Why didn't you just, like, send your location... And then say help.
You're gonna do something, you're gonna do it right. Here we go. Go on. Cry for help. Cry for help.
Help?
Oh, pathetic. No, cry for help.
That was a cry for help.
You mean it, boy. Help! From your diaphragm! Help! Shh. Now we listen. Nothing.
Maybe try from the other corner. Yeah, probably because you have a fork in you.
Find out what he knows.
Don't throw the blood fork.
Now, please, stay right here. Enjoy the crab rangoon. Don't move. I will be right back. Yuma, we need...
What is that? What is that? What's happening? The screen just was all weird. You know, I get it. My computer's not that powerful. I understand. But, like, wow, did that not load up correctly? And those things aren't even like, swaying. What happened to my seat? Wasn't I sitting? Whoa, there we are. Can I not sit? So, a question... Why can't I enjoy the crab rangoon? It's right there. Okay.
Fuck.
So yeah, about that crab rangoon. Like, which one is that? I mean, I think it's right in front of me. Is that it? I can't see. The lighting setting isn't that good. Partially because I don't actually, you know, have the good specs for that, and I also don't have the means to get a whole bunch of money in a short amount of time. Like, seriously, job market is hard and things are expensive. Okay, that's happening again. Wait, nope, that's down there. Can I see what's happening down there? Huh. Anyways, so I see the money flashing, and I feel it would be rude to take it. Like, really rude. Like, he didn't... I mean, he left it there. Okay, no, that's not enough to just... You know, what does he think that's going to sound like to me? Like, right now, he thinks I'm just going to sit here and be okay with it? Well, then again, that could function as a threat. Like, a legit threat. I don't think the screen is supposed to look like that. What's happening? Okay. Yeah, alright, cool. That's fine too. And again. Sure, whatever. Also, wow, those are just monkeys. Like, is that just decoration? Did they, like, get four monkeys? Just, like, one general body of a monkey and just, like, stick them together? Are we going to eat the monkeys? Also, all this food is going to waste. I'm not eating it for some odd reason. There's no button to eat the crab rangoon. He told me to enjoy it. What if he comes back? You know he's crazy. You know he's crazy. What if he comes back? It's like, oh, well, you don't like crab rangoon? Then get out of my life. And he throws you off that cliff. Or, probably worse, dependent, you get to be the guy who's electrocuted. And, you know, I'm sure we don't like that. But man, this crab stuff reminds me of the time I went to Red Lobster. Not now, man. I'm telling a story. Anyways, so I went to America. Wait, what? What was that? I heard something. Oh god, the monkeys are coming alive! Oh. Never mind. What was I doing? Oh, right, yeah. So, I've gone to America 3 times in my life. One was off when I was 4, one when I was 16, and one when I was, how old am I now? 21? 21. And so, the thing is that, just like, I've always had going to Red Lobster on my bucket list. Because it always seemed like I saw those stuff in commercials on TV, and just like, oh man, that's what I need in my life. And so when I actually got there, well, first I tried pink lemonade, definitely not as good as normal lemonade. But then I got the something, I think, was it the three shrimp platter? It was three different types of shrimp, like served differently. One was fried with fries, one was like in with spaghetti, and I forget what the other one was, but that was amazing. And not only that, but there was, well, there was, I forget, it was either king or snow crab. And we had one, and there was like barely any meat, and usually that's just like a disappointing thing, and just like, ugh, oh well. But we actually, my mom actually like said, hey, there's barely any meat. There's barely any meat in this. And even though we already ate some of it, they just like replaced it with no extra cost. And like, wow, that's a thing that happens? Something isn't right with your food and people actually just replace it without an issue? That's shocking. But, well, okay. I'm not saying like that's impossible, but like, we already ate some of the food. Usually that voids the warranty of sorts. Anyways. The sauce. Maybe it was lobster sauce, maybe it was crab sauce, but it was one of the most delicious, savory things I have ever had in my entire life. It was so good. And I just, the thing is, usually these sauces look bad when you just get them. They're all weird and chunky. And unless they have cheese in them, usually I'm skeptical. Especially if they're closer to the color white than anything. But I had it and it was just heaven. The person I was with also had like nacho chips. So I just had nacho chips with the sauce, and then I put the shrimp in the sauce and the fries in the sauce. The sauce was so good. Oh man. There are certain things that disappointed me about that America trip, but getting something off of my bucket list, truly, truly a highlight. Like, I don't have a lot of, it's hard for me to process a lot of memories. I don't have a lot of good ones. Usually most of my processing is bad ones. It's almost a psychological problem. I should really get that checked out. But just, I can remember that vividly. And the fact that I can remember it vividly and have positive feelings towards it, and it doesn't take too much effort on my part, means that it was truly an amazing experience. Oh man, I want to go back to Red Lobster. I want to go back to Popeyes too. They got my order wrong, like, the first time, but they actually gave me more chicken strips than, like, I ordered. Little audio glitch there. Just ignore it. So, he's taking forever with that torture. I guess that's more credit for the guy. He's all stone cold, resisting all that electrocution. Or maybe he already told them the truth and they're just doing that for funsies. I mean, you'd think, like, something would have given at this point. We're watching and we're waiting. Okay, screen, that's fine. I'm just gonna turn over here and we're gonna pretend that didn't happen. Seriously, it's food. It's gonna get cold. It's cold. The chefs who prepared this, look. I know it's fake food, but I hate seeing wasted food, all right? I love eating. I love I love having food, and I kind of like preparing food, even though I'm not that good at it, partially because of my impatience and lack of attention. However, I'd like to also point out that just knowing that people spend so much time and effort making things, making these things in food, making all this food and everything, and it just goes to waste, even just like in a media form, it just stings me. This thing is hard to get right, you know? And, you know, it's also insulting to people who don't have food, don't have good food. Why wouldn't I eat the crab rangoon? I mean, in normal circumstances, I guess my instinct would be to leave, so I wouldn't do that, but, like, come on, people worked hard on this! I guess maybe that's the reason why I would probably not do well in Far Cry. I'm just way too nice. On the edge of our seats, anticipating. It's looking awful permanent, but we know it could go away. We're keeping our eyes peeled, keeping them glued to the spot. Cause one moment it's there, but then the next maybe not. Okay, so a question then, but seriously, this is all super psychedelic and everything, I get it, but the lighting isn't supposed to be this bad, this computer's an i5! When did Far Cry 4 come out? I actually don't know. So it's, you know, he's actually being a terrible host. He left me for a good, what is that? There's something right there. You saw that, right? I didn't make that up? I probably made that up. Nope. I guess it's the lighting effects going all weird, or maybe that's a leaf. Not fully sure. Man, though. This is some nice spread, though. You know, this actually reminds me. Yes, I know. Smug Diesel's going all story time here. Well, I'm sorry, but he left me here with the food. It'd be rude to just leave, okay? Like, what if I got up, like, right now? Like, with the amount of time I've been talking, he would just, like, come back in, and then he'd be all like, oh, hey, just, so you were going to leave? Like, no, look, man, you were gone for, like, so much time. And he'd be like, oh, super impatient, huh? I'm gonna stab you with this electric laser. I'm gonna shoot you with this electric laser. Just like what's happening to that guy back down there. Except it's probably less a laser and more a chair. Seriously, though. Like, I advocate for your freedom and everything, but can somebody either rescue him? Can he either keel over or give up the answers? And does Pagan Min have to supervise everything? What is going on again? I'm gonna have to play this on low settings, aren't I? Seriously, look at the floor. Oh wow, this is getting worse. Can you not process a whole bunch of like small stuff at one time when I'm moving? This is gonna suck in combat. Ugh. Whatever. Yes, we get it, you're in pain. You know, the problem with all of this is that this just reminds me of how, back when I was a kid, whenever there was food laid out for me, I just, like, immediately just, like, devour it. But while I still have a high metabolism now, it's not the same. I mean, I guess that's because I'm at home doing less than nothing sometimes. You know, not for lack of trying to do anything else, but still, less than nothing. The problem is that I wish I could eat more, but I guess it's a blessing in disguise. Because if I wanted to eat more, then that's more money. And I don't have more money at all. There's money on the table over there. I mean, I could always get that. But I know how this works. The moment I move, the very moment that I move, he's gonna come in, and he's gonna get it. Like, seriously. Did we finish already? Ugh. You know, I wish I had my phone. Do I not have my phone? Oh, well, according to what happened, the guys, they didn't check for the guy's phone at all. So, you know, I should still have it. Why aren't I calling for help? Like, actually, with the phone calling for help. I don't know. Maybe I'm lazy. Maybe I've forgotten. Maybe it's the terror or the hunger that I am not satiating. The food is right there. There should be a button. Should be a button to just go eat. Just go eat. Just... Is there a button to, like, sit down and eat? No? Yes? Ah, man.
Oh, man, bloody bastard. You, sir, are a...
And you are incorporeal.
I sincerely apologize. We saw terrorists in the area and yada yada.
Seriously, stop doing that.
The crab rangoon, right? It's...
I think his scream is destroying the dimension.
Mm. Well, come on, let's go.
Okay, but, you know, all of this is getting cold. I think it's kind of disrespectful. Realistically speaking, if I'm sitting all the way down there, all down here and doing less than nothing, you'd think that just being hungry enough, I would try this stuff.
You know, part of me is surprised your mother asked for you to bring her all the way back here. Thank you, Kamran. You want me to follow? Jesus Christ. Yes, boy, the ashes aren't going to scatter themselves.
Okay, I mean, technically they would if we just dumped them.
Did your mother ever tell you about your father?
Never know.
Mohan, the great protector of the Golden Path. Was a cunt.
Cool, not saying that word.
Fell in love. Child. And that is when Mohan showed his true colors.
Can we focus on what just happened?
You and your mother away. Even killed your sister, Lakshmana. Which brings us here.
So I apparently had a sister.
Lakshmana shouldn't be alone anymore. I'm so glad we're finally back.
It's really windy out here.
After you.
Well then, is there a button for that? In loving memory of Lakshmana Min. Okay. Wait. Well, this was easy. It just took waiting a little bit. You know, that was easy. Apparently, that's my sister. She's cute. There's not really much else I can say here. Or not. This is the part where I accidentally tipped something over. Something was sparkling. Is that a book? Collect? Fun Games Journal. Anything else? Oh, whoa, I almost kicked something. I did not know that I was supposed to do something. Okay, cool. Good thing. I'm just gonna be over here and open the door. Hopefully he's not mad that I took those papers.
Oh, good. Do you feel better now? Get it out of your system?
Did you see the kick? I hope not.
Maybe now we can finally shoot some goddamn guns.
We can what? What happened? I think we skipped the part about shooting those goddamn guns.
Darling, you got to let me know. Should I stay or should I go? If you say that you are mine.
I'll be here till the end of time. So you got to let me know, should I stay or should I go? It's always tease, tease, tease. You're happy when I'm on my knees. One day is fine, the next is black. So if you want me off your back, well come on and let me know, should I stay or should I go? Should I stay or should I go now? Should I stay or should I go now? If I go there will be trouble, decisions bugging me.
Indecision, they molest us.
If you don't want me, set me free.
Set me careless,
exactly whom I'm supposed to be.
Yeah.
Don't you know which clothes even fit me? Come on and let me know. Should I cool it or should I blow? Should I go now? Should I stay or should I go now? If I go there will be trouble, and if I stay it will be double. So you gotta let me know, should I cool it or should I blow? Should I stay or should I go now?
ਦੇ ਦਿਲ ਪਰਦੇਸੀ ਨੂੰ ਤੈਨ ਨਿਤ ਦਾ ਰੋਣਾ ਪੈ ਜਾਊਗਾ ਮਾਂ ਦੇ ਦਿਲ ਪਰਦੇ